in this tutorial, we are going to know about how to create this smooth transitional effect on the drop-down navigation menu list items, and on the other hand, we will be witnessing how to create this kind of animation effect on individual list items of this second unordered list. Hello and welcome to another new episode of Learning Simplified. In this tutorial, we are going to witness how to create these smooth transitional effects on individual list items of the second order unordered list, and on the other hand, we will be creating some more text and background effects as we can see over here. Now let's hop into our tutorial. We have created this index.html page and this stylesheet.css page. Now in this stylesheet.css, so far I have created this navigation menu and I have created an index.html, and inside this index.html I have created all those sort of things like this list items. This is the first order list, and this here goes the second order list. And if we observe the output of the things so far coded, then we may witness that this kind of appearance is. So this is the thing that we have to reorganize and decorate. Now let's get back to stylesheet.css. Although those have been coded over here, all those things are defining the first order list items. You see, here's the first order list item. All these things are first order list items. In this case, I have taken a container class name. This is the container class name that has been created over here, which has a width of 1000 pixels, height auto. I have kept the height auto. The background of it is black, pure black, and the margin is 50 pixels auto, and that is why it is leaving a gap of 50 pixels from the top. So I am customizing that unordered list that has been created over here. Here goes the unordered list, and I have provided this list style to none. That means there won't be any bulleted text format. And I have kept this position to relative, and I uplifted the Z index value to 1000. Then I have customized the list item. I kept this list item floating left. The margin for each individual list items will be leaving a 2 pixels gap from both left and right. And I have kept the position relative again in case of individual list items. Then I have created an anchor tag over here under this list item. Now up to this part it is okay and all right, but we have already introduced a second order list item inside this first order list item, but this not yet been customized. So this is what we need to customize first. So that is why we are getting back to our code, and here we are customizing it. Now we have previously made the position as relative. Now this time I am making this position absolute. Why it is 180 pixels? Because we have placed this individual list item anchor tag as width 180 pixels, and the same exact thing we are wanting over here. This will be having a total width of 180 pixels, such that it comes right beneath this individual list item. So that is why we have constrained this width to 180 pixels. Now another important issue, place this height, restrict this height to 0 pixels. We have placed this height to 0 pixels, and on transition condition, standard syntax here. Now the question is, what will be happening over here? Whenever we are inserting our mouse in, we see whenever we just hover into this particular service box, all we can see here that in this particular case a drop down list is descending down. That means there wasn't any height in the previous case, but on mouse hovering it is now descending down to a particular height, as we can witness over here. So this is the thing that we are about to do here. Now we have placed this height to 0 pixels. So up to this far, if we just get back to our project and reload, now we can see that already there's been a drop down list which has been appeared over here. Now let's make the hover action. So all we are doing here, another thing that we have to provide over here is this one, overflow. All you need to do, you need to mention the nature of this animation. So I am providing here is. Now if we just get back to our project and reload, now we can see that on mouse hovering, a particular drop down list is descending down. And why this height is 200 pixels? We have provided 5 list items over here in this second order unordered list. And another thing, we have provided a total line height of 40 pixels. This is the line height which has a total height of 40 pixels. That means 5 into 40 pixels, 200 pixels. And that is why we have provided this height to 200 pixels. And this is what it is executing right now. It is just dropping down to 200 pixels, showing all the list items inside this item. But you see that on mouse hovering on others, there is no such drop down list, because we never mentioned any kind of drop down list over here. And that is why the only part which is executing this kind of animation is the services segment, which has a second order unordered list to play, to come in action. Now the second thing is, we need to customize all these things. That means on mouse hovering on these individual list items, these backgrounds will be changed, and the color of these text elements, those will be changed over here. So what we are doing, we are now getting back over here. First of all, provide this background color. For say I am providing this yellow color over here, on mouse hovering this thing will be executed. So if we just reload, now if we just come below, we can see that the background color is also getting changed. And you want to change the font color, so all you need to do, you need to get back to your project and change the font color to red. Suppose I am changing this font color to red, and we can see that this thing is happening, but this is also without animation. So we need to provide some animation over here. Now get back to your project and reload. Now you can see that there is a transitional effect which is going on for 1 second. All these things are getting changed. And another thing, this is the last thing of this tutorial. Now we are providing another kind of animation easing, animation nature, which is known as cubic bezier. You know that this is practically a cubic bezier cubic. That means there will be 4 points. Among these 4 points, the position of 2 points are static, always static, which is 0,0 condition and the 1,1 condition. That is why the highest value of cubic bezier always remains to 1 and the lowest value always remains to 0. So the rest of the 2 points, that means the x1 and x2 point on x axis and the y1 and y2 point on y axis should be determined here. Now this is practically a very difficult thing to observe, to determine the total actual amount of this cubic bezier, but thanks to Leah Vareu, a scholar of Massachusetts University of Technology or MIT, she is a PhD scholar, and she has determined a new technique to determine the cubic bezier valuation. So if we just get here, we can see that this is the website which has been designed by Leah Vareu. Here she is, Leah Vareu, and she has created this website where we may determine the actual coordination of these points. These are the 2 points that we were talking about. This actually determines what kind of animation it will be observing over here. These are known as handlers. Now if you just extend these handlers, if you just change the valuation of these handlers, you may see that these valuations are also getting changed over here. You see, now I am just changing the position of x1 and x2 points over here, and you will see that these points are getting changed. Now if you want to change the y1 and y2 coordination, you need to hold these things and you see that these values, the last of these two values, those are also getting changed. Now let's suppose that you want as in this case, and here goes the value that it has already been calculated, it has already calculated over here. All you need to know now, you just go to save and you see that here comes the valuation in this pop-up dialog box. So all you need to do, you need to copy these valuations. Now get back to your project and over here you just paste it down. So now just press Ctrl S and get back to your project. If you just get to this individual list items, you may see that the same animation, that the same cubic bezier properties is been observed over here. For say we are just increasing this time duration over here to make it proper, and we are creating a particular another kind of animation technique. If you compare between these two valuations, just go preview and compare and press this button, and you can see this kind of animation will be happening over here. So this is what we are doing. We can see that this will be the animation effect. This red box will be the animation effect, actually what it will be showing into your web browser, into your project. So this is what we are going to take. So press Ctrl S, get back to your project. Now you see it is first starting at a faster speed and then it is getting slower again. So this is how you will be determining the cubic bezier method. So this is what we are going to know. This is what we have learned from today's tutorial. As we can see that the background as well as the color is getting changed, and it is getting changed in a cubic bezier fashion, and it has some particular values that can be determined from layer values website. As we can see, this is the curve for linear, for ease. This is the curve for linear, ease in, ease out, ease in out. So this is what you can do. The link is provided in the description below. You may take the advantage of determining the valuation of cubic bezier with the aid of our site. We may observe that here comes a slight mismatch in width. So all we need to do, and we can see that the mismatch has been solved, it's been fixed over here. So I hope you have liked this tutorial. If you have liked our tutorial, then please do not hesitate to hit that red subscribe button over there. And this is the last of the segments of this animation techniques. In the next tutorial, we are going to complete our project that we were practically using on. This was the project actually that we were working on previously. In the next tutorial, what we are going to learn, we will be concentrating on this form item, and we need to make a customized form field as we can see. Hope to see you guys in our next. Till then, bye.